something I haven't been paying attention to is my little smaller towns here. So what I'm going to do, like for here, I actually have a greater population in Pafensi than I do in some of my larger, you know, small minor cities. So this guy actually has two spearmen in him. So we're going to recruit some more there and have these guys march on up. So let's see here. I can recruit, you know what, more spearmen here. So let's do that. Guildford. Yeah, we have Norman rule. Good. I can recruit some more men here if I really needed to. In fact, I think I do, because my west is kind of weak. So I think I can even take these guys out. Yes, I can. Perfect. We will. You know what? We'll also throw them up this way.
We shall camp here.
All right. What's your... Yeah, you're that. I mean, sorry, I was just looking at the political thing. Oh, we could actually get some men out of there as well. Okay, we'll definitely do that. There's really no point. Oh, what's the, would I be able to convert you? Well, not really, because it's its own island, so it would just have... I wonder if it would... No, low taxes, public order. I think I'd take a pretty big hit because of the... They're used to their customary law. I'd actually have to have a family member there to actively convert them. How are we doing here? Yeah, they're still with their customary law. We're still waiting to change the hearts and minds of the local population. More minds than anything else. Okay, Oxenford is also rebellious, so no point in recruiting serfs, but man, with their population, I probably could start pumping out quite a few spearmen as well. Okay, just look at these guys up here. Oh, as far as recruitment goes. Okay, they're at a high tax rate. Let's do something like that. And, yeah, you know what? More spearmen. Benford... They're at a high tax rate. Another regional thing. I wouldn't be able to convert them. How about here? I can't recruit anything. Once again, they're used... Holy cow, are they ever used to feudal lordship.
Senior.
I mean, not a feudal lordship, a local law. Hartford, I think, is the closest thing I could do to... converting them. In order to do that, I would have to convert... Well, we'll wait till I conquer this area, and then we'll slowly work on this chunk on converting them into the feudal rule. There's no need to rush that, actually. Alright, so I have 20 grand to spend this time, so let's do it in our large towns in England first. So let's see here. Population not so bad, so let's see, a cider hall or merchant. You know what, I'm going to build this slipway because this is a pretty big, that's a pretty significant trade income, so we'll do that. Ludenvik, you need to really kind of that's a significant increase too. A spy network. That's interesting. Spies who reside in a settlement with a spy network will receive training and expect to advance more rapidly through the levels of Eavesdropper, Footpad, Shadowmaster, Spy, and Mastermind. That's neat. Oh, what the hey? Let's do that. That seems like fun. Besides, as far as the military goes, I'm floating around 2,000, so... yeah, let's not. Okay, Windcaster. What else do we have? A shipwright. Wow. That's nice. Another spy network if I want. A Christian church. Could be very good. I really want to up... Ooh, a royal mint. Very nice. Anything I can do to increase the population growth bonus. Can a trader do that? Yes, it can. So, we're gonna do that. And Oxenford. Well, we already know what we're doing for them. Okay. Alright, so now we're going to go through all of our small towns and see if there's anything here that we can build. Okay, so a mustard field there, drinking hall there, priories, a bunch of priories. Let's see here. No. Northampton, drinking hall, get drunk, the priory, and that's about it. Okie dokie. And so let's check on with mainland Normandy. Still lots of money, 10 grand. Wow. Okay, a water mill. That will increase trade goods and public growth. And how much does that cost? 4,000. Or you can just have a regular cider house. That's kind of neat. Oh, how about just a merchant for monetary reasons? We can do improved farms here. Would that increase my... Oh yeah, by about 70, and that would increase 2. What else do we have? A market. Oh yeah, it would actually increase by less. Oh, my population's pretty big here, though. So it's not like I would really need it. Master Blacksmith could be fun. Or Stockade. Or Royal Court. Let's do the improved farms. No big deal. Cane. Basic farms for you. And finally... Oh, we have just a little bit of money left over. So we could build a... just a simple little cider hall, I suppose. Yeah. Perfect. Not even over budget. That's good. Okay, so looking with my spy, I have a 75% chance of getting inside the town, and a 75% chance of working with this single unit. So you know what? We're gonna take a chance. Oh goodness! Yay, he didn't die. I probably should have sent him there for training, but there we go. Wow, this is a really good holdout. This would be a really good place for us to expand. Yeah, perfect. Good to know. I wonder if I can sabotage anything. I don't know if I'd even want to. 60% chance, nah. Instead, let's use our assassin as, once again, a kind of a rudimentary spy. So there's a little something there. A little something here. Okay. But that should be easy to guard against. And then our emissary. Maybe we should send our emissary up to Wales, since the English don't want to deal with us. They would be the first that we come across, the Welsh or the Scots, yeah. Yeah, let's see what they're up to. So, we know that the Welsh are up here, so we'll send them kind of this way. We'll take a look at his... Nah, never mind. Oh, yeah. Actually, surprised the Welsh didn't actually attack. Do I want to go through this way? Sure. Through the mountains. I'm surprised actually the Welsh have, or the Scottish haven't actually attacked the vulnerable English. Oh no, they have. And the Norse have too. Oh god, the English are screwed. Alright, let's start out with our military plans. Let's have these guys meet up with Richard Fitzgilbert. And should I send a few more clerics up with them? No, there's actually a few units up here in Northampton. So instead, we're going to simply move him down this stretch of road. Oh, we'll have him build a watchtower right here. It's been a while since we built a watchtower. And we're going to go ahead and move on up this way. Can these guys actually meet up with him? Oh, they can. Let's not, though. Let's just wait, because they could always just try to attack this town, and I might as well try to have as many defenders there as possible. Okay, and let's continue on here, see what we have. This doesn't look like much of a threat. Ooh, we can actually assault them this turn. We might want to do that. Stokesman. Spearmen, how many archers do I have? Ooh, a lot of archers. Yeah, we're gonna attack them this turn, but let me just finish moving the rest of my military units. Let's just send them in there. Same thing with these guys. Same thing with these fellows. And you can make your way up north too. We shall camp here. You Senior. Will head over to Windcaster. You guys
Senior.
Yeah, with the hay. You go Senior. In there. As do you. And okay, so this is a slow march towards them here, but that's perfect. Perfect. Oxenford. Oh, they built here. I'll build some spearmen there, and that will have them chill out a little bit too. Oh, and these guys. You know what? You just stay there because you're kind of right on the edge of everything. Okay, I think we're done moving our military units. Let's actually have a fight for once, eh? Alright, so let's assault. Yeah. Hopefully they don't stand a prayer. They do... No, they don't even have walls either. Oh, perfect. I'll see you on the battle map. Alright, so this is my setup. A double kind of winged approach, very similar as before. Just gonna shoot the ever-loving crap out of them until they come out and face me, fix them with the infantry, charge them with the cavalry, and everything will be a-okay. So let's start the battle and see if any of them have decided to start outside. And some of them have. Foolish. Okay, so... Oh, my archer's already firing there, so let's just bring up this wing in the meantime. And bring them up to about... Can I move them any closer than that? No, not quite. Okay. We'll just bring them up to there. You know what? Give them a little jog, have them run. And we'll watch the show here. Oh, excellent. They're even coming right up towards me. Perfect. Well, if there's one thing I've definitely learned, it's that we can't give them a chance to fire off their missile weapons. So we're actually going to charge them with all my infantry. Well, most of it, except for maybe the clerics. And we're going to have these guys circle around this side. And we'll have this guy circle around this side. And see what happens. And they're broken already. Wonderful. So we can just get these guys set to continue on. We'll have them run. We'll have my cav chase down these rotors. Oh, and we have some stokesmen here. Now they're making a run for it. Very wise, stokesmen. Very wise. No, I think my cavalry can probably clean them up pretty easily. Yeah, you know what? Let's give that a shot. Let's just take these guys off of fire well so they don't accidentally shoot my own men. And let's see what a cavalry charge will do. Because they are axemen. They don't even have spears, which means my cavalry would not be nearly as vulnerable. Uh-oh. I saw them saying reloading. I was concerned with them. Yeah, they're broken. Yeah, they were inferior class, so that will be pretty easy to... That's pretty easy to clean up. Oh, some peasants here, too. Oh, this is gonna just be so much easier. Okay, well, forget about these guys. I don't think I'd be able to set up my weird, crazy formation here, and... Oh my goodness, I can. It's not exactly how I wanted it. So let's just modify it. Do that. No, actually, go a little bit closer. That. The infantry. Right behind. Our clerics. And you guys can hang out here. Yeah, you guys can hang out there. Perfect. You know what? You don't even have to run. I'll have them walk at a leisurely pace. What about these guys? Could I at least get them set up? Oh, I can't get them set up like that. I do like that. Perfect. Anyways, I'm gonna just have them walk. So I'll come back in once we start round number two. Okay, we are all set. So let's select all my archers. And we're going to tell them to let loose. And see where these poor sods go.
We're under attack! They're attacking us!
The peasants aren't even a thought. Okay, so it looks like the Lightfird are heading towards my men here. Perfect. So that means, I could probably charge them from behind this cavalry. And we're gonna just bring my infantry up ahead to charge them. And we'll actually get ready for these guys to do kind of a bit of a frontal charge, coordinated with the rear charge. Okay, so we're gonna have these archers stop firing. There's really no need. There we are. Oh, it looks like they're retreating, though. What are you doing? I want to fight you. Oh, now they're coming this way. Oh, dear. Make up your minds. Well, alright. Very well. We'll have these guys stop firing now, too. And have my infantry here. Give him a charge. We'll circle around this cavalry. And we will push forward with the cavalry that I have over here. Bring around here. Maybe we'll just take a couple units. You can just chill out, dude. Okay. Let's try to cut these ones off. Cut them off. Ah, this stupid town square. Nah, forget it. Alright, we're just gonna have to just crush him with my infantry. Okay, Calv. You can get out of there now. I'll just do a few repeated charges on their rear, if I ever get the chance. Okay, you guys, line up here. Except for you, you don't need to. Ah, crap, they even got to throw in some of their stupid... their stupid javelins. There we go. Come on. There we go. Killed their general. Okay, so let's just pull out the cav. Charge, and that should probably break them at that point. Okay. Yeah, they're going flying. Love it. I'm even gonna just keep my cavalry in there. They're, I can't even see the enemy at this point. Oh, there goes one. But I think I won. Did I win? Oh, dude, my guys are so... There we go. Yes, I did. Yeehaw! How many did I lose? 3%? Eh, not bad. Not bad. Okay, 52 kills, 52 losses, actually. That's pretty good. All right, I'll see you back at the camp. All right, so once again here, I have another option. I can either enslave or lay them to waste. We're going to enslave them. That doesn't do anything great, but we're going to, you know, put up some local lordship, which will calm them down. I'll lower the taxes. Can't really retrain anything, but... Well, I can retrain, but I think it's because I have a blacksmith here? Yeah, blacksmith. That's pretty neat. Well, you know what, actually? Sure. I think my bodyguard knights deserve some retraining, as do my armored spearmen. Let's see, my clerics, and my cavalry. And, well, let's throw in, you know, a few of those guys there. Perfect, so it looks like I have two more territories to go. I only see one here, though. But if I zoom in, yeah, that's clearly two, so obviously there's someone somewhere around here too, so we'll have to deal with them. Yeah, so we'll just take a moment here and for this turn, and have, you know, things settle down before we continue on our conquest in the east. Oh hey, and this town expanded. That's fantastic. So now we're gonna make ourselves a wooden castle. Neat.